Well, good afternoon. Great to be here. Great to join the stage with the state of Neal, and really appreciate my fellow Colorado mayors here from Golden and from Aspen and from Boulder. So we're really glad to be here. I'm glad to be here. I'm talking about what Fort Collins is doing with regards to becoming a carbon neutral city and giving a little bit of the history and then how are we organized as a city organization to meet our community's goals. With that, I'm in my second term as mayor and on the faculty at Colorado State University of Mechanical Engineering. And I work in the area of intelligent control of distributed systems, and it started out as robotics, and then 20 years ago I've done it in the electric systems and what is now smart grid. So I've been part of smart grid for about 20 years now. And before I was elected to council about 10 and a half years ago, we were doing projects related to smart grid and integration. And so I kind of had that flavor. And then I've also taught our energy engineering class for our junior level students in mechanical engineering. So I take that perspective as well. I'm also on the systems engineering faculty. So I only say those things because it provides context as to where I'm coming from. Not only as mayor of our community, but it gives some background as to how I think about things. I've also started as mayor something called the Futures Committee. And it's an opportunity, it's a subcommittee of council where we talk about things not on our agenda. And it's lifting our head up and looking out and looking more horizontally. Are we on the right vector, not necessarily at the destination? And it gives us an opportunity to actually think and discuss, bring in thought leaders, and it's created some conversations in our community that have come to fruition. Oftentimes, you get bogged down into the incremental day-to-day, what's next week sort of issues, and this gives us an opportunity to lift and discuss our future kinds of issues. And with that, we zoom out, and then I think it also helps with the framing of the issues such that they can be accepted by the community. Fort Collins, I would say, is a purple community, and because of that, we've had good support across our community for our climate action goals. And we're currently 167,000 in our population, and we're targeted to be 250,000 in about 2040. So, and that's our build-out. We've done the analysis of our community, and that would be our build-out in about 2040. Colorado State University is a top research land-grant university, and we think in our relationship, and I talked about university cities as a strategic initiative where we not only are town-down, but it's also an opportunity for us to partner intentionally and have alignment on things that help us do things that the city can't do, the university can't do, and the private sector can't do independently. By getting that overall alignment, we're better off. We're a council manager form of government. We're four municipal utilities, electric, wastewater, stormwater, and wastewater. And we're taking broadband to the citizens in November as perhaps a fifth utility. As I said, we're purple, and one of the things that we're often talked about is a place of invention. The picture here is we're in the Smithsonian as a place of invention. It's an exhibit that's showing at the U.S. Museum of American History. It shows six cities, five were in the past, Hartford, Connecticut in the 1880s, for example, Silicon Valley in the 1960s, Hollywood in the 1930s around film technology, and then Fort Collins is featured in the 2010s going forward around clean renewable energy, and really talking about how we moderate partnerships and that sort of thing in order to have a more sustainable, greener future. And so I show this one just to put into perspective that how we think of ourselves as an innovation community, a community of invention, and that comes to get to our climate action plan as a climate economy. We really think about really creating solutions locally that can be scaled and other communities as well. So one of the hallmarks, I think, of Fort Collins is that we're aspirational as a community, but we're also very pragmatic, and we couple those two. So there's this pragmatism of bringing to the community what you need. In terms of our climate action plan, I was on the council, voted unanimously 2015 for 80% carbon reductions against 2005 by 2030, and then 100% by 2050. And where are we right now? So we're 12% reduction towards our 2020 goal, so we're more than halfway there as we voted on this in 2015. And then also we're down 28% per capita since 2005, and since our population has grown in that regard. So we truly take a triple bottom line approach to this in terms of how it benefits not only our economic prosperity, our businesses, we have documented savings for them, but also diverting 60% from our landfill in terms of waste, and doubling our transit ridership in 10 years, providing social benefits, for example. And to put it into context, I'm going to develop our infrastructure, if you will, for implementation. And starting with the community, I believe it's in our community ethos since about 1997, when we first had conversations, we built it in our city plan with goals in 1999. And it's one of our strategic outcome areas, 7 strategic outcome areas as a part of our strategic plan. And our CAP goals stem from quality of life, cost effectiveness, and innovation, and solutions oriented going forward. Next is the council. And I mentioned the unanimous vote in 2015. And it's built into our budgeting for outcomes process. As I said, we had 7 outcomes areas, and we don't fund departments, we fund outcomes. And so when offers come forward as a part of the budgeting process, they're for outcomes in our community. So one of the things that, as we go around this in this work here, things have to be measurable that move the dial. A lot of things are nice to do, and they might be make somebody feel good, but does it really move the dial? And given aggressive climate goals, you really have to move the dial. So we really have to put the best of the money where it really can make a difference. And that's where we have discussions and focus on moving the dial. We talk about leading by example, and one of the ways we do that is the city is a platform, and I'll talk more about that. Next is our CAP executive team. So this is an executive team that involves our city manager, our chief sustainability officer, our chief financial officer, and our utilities executive director, and so forth. You can see them listed on the right there. And this is where they meet week bi-weekly, and keep you focused on outcomes related to our climate action plan. Next is our core team. And our core team have these 11 areas. Some of them our core team, they're cross-functional. And then there are communication between the CAP executive team and individual teams that focus on implementation. Our core team meets monthly. So our strategic initiatives teams, there's 11 teams here. They fall into 2 areas. There's the technical teams that focus directly on initiatives that drive reductions, and then our support teams that help focus on ideas that help to influence and educate and communicate. And so, again, our core team, our strategic initiative teams really are driving how we actually move the dial, if you will. And finally is our CAP community advisory team. And this is really built from individuals throughout our community, through our Triple Helix, public sector, private sector research university. It also helps to reflect our triple bottom line, the economic, environmental, and social goals of our community, and this group meets quarterly. One of the things I'd like to point out here is a recent challenge, an Innovate Fort Collins challenge that we had, where we did a reverse RFP. We asked for proposals that actually to help us meet our climate action goal, 2020 goals, and for $250,000, we had that to award for 2 years in each of the years. And what we're looking to do is to take $1 to solve a $10 problem and to help leverage. And so what we're trying to do is find solutions and cost share and matching for people that can bring proposals to us that can help move the dial within our community. And I mentioned the climate economy, and that's an important aspect. And so taking our vision to results, starting with a city plan or outcomes areas, and moving to our strategic plan, which is has a five-year planning horizon, and moving to our budgeting for outcomes, which is done every 2 years, with the seven outcomes areas that there offers each time that meet our outcomes, and again, not funding departments. And then taking those offers, and then having, we have a dashboard and we have a climate action plan dashboard with measurables that we can track to see how we're doing meeting our goals. And so moving this transformation, basically we're moving from the centralized generation model, if you will, as Steve and Neil talked about, we're really talking about energy fundamentally. And that's where, as we get down to cities and city implementations, the discussions here is where the rubber meets the road and how do you really affect change as opposed to, as I say, shout at the moon. And so you really, and what are the specific things that you can do to do that? And moving more to an integrated system that, we can plan for an exit for coal, looking at more distributed energy resources and integrating those within our community, talking about conservation as well as behavioral change in the process as well. And just to give some examples, some energy examples, one was, we have community solar projects. We have one of 650 kilowatt, which was sold out before it was even built. And that's next to our wastewater facility, and people actually buy specific gas components of that the community solar. Then Platte River Power Authority, which I sit on that board, it's just the last year we commissioned a 30 megawatt solar, rawhide solar flats in conjunction with its conventional coal as well as natural gas. And then Energy Works. And just the picture on the right there is the bank that, and it's always had this time and temperature on the top. They converted that to LED and are saving over $1,000 per month on an energy bill just by that technology change. Next is our waste reduction and doing a number of things there, focusing on waste management and thinking of waste not something to do away with or recycle per se or necessarily reuse, but think about the whole energy management of waste holistically. We have biosolids project where we spread our solid waste as a nutrient. Road to Zero Waste, where we're moving towards 75% reduction, making things easier for our citizens to do things. And then in transportation systems, and we talked about intelligent transportation systems. This afternoon, we're demonstrating in Fort Collins a project with CDOT, the Colorado Department of Transportation, on a autonomous vehicle that is a training vehicle for a striping truck. A training vehicle, it has been a manned driving training vehicle that is a crash vehicle just in case somebody runs into it. And so we're demonstrating an autonomous trailing vehicle for a striping operation that will probably get picked up in the news, and you might see that. Basically thinking about open data, where we have all of our city data sources open for solutions from within our community. So traffic systems and to improve our system efficiencies. And then the systems integration related to multimodal bike, ride, and car sharing programs, and thinking that as holistically with our transit systems. And then planning for more autonomous systems in the future. And then next is really our partnership and collaboration relationships. And there's the climate action agenda from the mayor's been, and the three mayors here from Colorado are part of the compact of Colorado communities. And then a number of other power authority, our generation transmission operator, which is critical in moving more to distributed resources at our community level. Our largest energy user and partner being the Research University of Colorado State University. And tactics such as Innovate Four Columns Challenge and City as a Platform, where we can help demonstrate and integrate being the community utility and transportation system and so forth. So if I'm just closing out the what's next for Four Columns and your communities, and this is, I'll leave this to you, but to set goals, align and leverage existing resources, understand your sources of emissions, and support energy efficiency, and I would say innovation, as well taking it in a systems perspective. And then our next steps in Four Columns is focused on 2020, the climate economy, organic waste solutions, alignment with city transportation and transit plans, which is what we're doing right now. And with that, thank you very much.